Okay guys, so today we will learn how to find the preorder, inorder and postorder of a binary tree. Let us see what does each and every instruction mean. P means print the child or the root we are currently on. L means go to the left root or child. R means go to the right child. Now for preorder, we see the instructions are PLR. It means first we need to print the node, then go to the left subtree and then go to the right subtree. For inorder it's LPR, for postorder it's LRP. While finding the orders, the traversal order, whichever that we are supposed to find, we remember three rules. Rule number one, each instruction is carried out sequentially on a node. You'll understand it when I do it. If no child node is present after executing the instruction, we return to the parent node. If no instructions are left to be executed, we return to the parent node. So the traversal finding starts with, first, we will write the sequence of instructions beside each node. For example, now you need to find the preorder. So you write PLR. Okay, now we start from the root node and we will execute the first instruction that we get on it. On the root node, we get the instruction P. P means print. So we will cancel it and we will write the value that is present. This is A. Now we see the second instruction. It's L. We cancel the value and we move to the left node. On the left node, the first instruction is P. So we cancel it and we write B. Okay. Now the second instruction is L. We go to the left and as per rule 2, we return back to P because it does not have any parent node. Sorry, it does not have any child node. Now the third instruction is R. We cancel it and we move to the right node. As you know, it does not have any child node, so L and R are cancelled. Now, as per rule 3, we go back to the parent node because there is no sequence of instructions that are left to be executed. Even here, there are no sequence A. Okay. Now A has just R left. So we cancel R. We move to the right to C. The first instruction of C is P. We write C. Now we go to the left. P. Then we cancel. We move to the left. Here the instruction is P. So we write H. No child node. No child node. Return back to this. To the parent. We move right. I. No child node, no child node. We move back to the parent node. No instructions left. We move back to the parent node. R. But there is no node. So it cancels. No instructions left. We move to the parent node. Again, no instructions left. We move to the parent node. No child node. R is cancelled. We get back to A. So you can see that we have written the preorder perfectly by writing the instruction sequence beside each and every node. You have to do the same for inorder and postorder also. Now for inorder, we write the sequence besides each node and we continue what we did for the preorder. For node, we start with the node, root node, and for root node A, we cancel L, move to the left. B, we cancel L, There is no child node. We move back to B. Now, P. The third instruction is R. We move to the right. As we can see, there are no child nodes of D. So left, we move back to D. Print D. We move to the right of D. There is no node. Back to D. Now all the instructions are executed. We move back to the parent node. Here also all the instructions are executed. We move back to the parent node. Now the instruction here left is P. We cut P and we write A. Now cut R. Get to the right. And C. We cut L. We get to the left. E, we cut L, there's no node. We come back to E, cut P. So it's, we move to the right, F. First instruction is L, we cut it, we move to left. G, we cut L, we move to the left. Here also we cut L, come back to H, print H. We see to the right, there is no node. We return to H. All the instructions are executed. We return to G. Print G. Go to the right of G. No child node. So we cut L. Return to I. Print I. No child node. We return to I. All the instructions executed. We return to G. We return to F. Print F. There is nothing to the right of F. So we cut. All the instructions are executed. We move to E. All instructions are executed. We move to C. We print C. Move to the right of C. There is no node. So we come back to C. Now all the instructions are executed properly. This is our inorder. So similarly, we will find the post order also. We start with the root A. And that is how we find the pre, in, and post order of a binary tree. Thank you.